Hi everybody, my name is Sarah Baya, and I'm so happy to be with you today. We're going to learn together about the Aleph. So the Aleph is the first letter in the alphabet, and it means master, one, teacher, and ox. And the Aleph doesn't like it about the ox. So if you want to hear more about his displeasure about being related to the ox, you can look under this video and find the link for animated letters, and he will tell you himself how he doesn't like. He thinks that people think he looks like an ox, and he doesn't like that. So anyway, the Aleph makes no sound. The Aleph is composed of a vav and two yuds, and the nice thing about this is that the vav is six and the two yuds are 10 each, so it's 20, so it's 26, which is the same number. Each of these letters has a number. It's the same number as the yud hey vav hey, name of God, which is unpronounceable, and that is the yud is 10, the two hays are 10, and the vav is 6, so it has the same numerical value. In the Sefer Yetzirah, which is thousands of years old, before the Common Era, and it was written in the Sefer Yetzirah that the world was created by 32 mystical paths of wisdom, and 10 of those paths is Sefirot, which we're not talking about today. And the 22 are the letters. So the Sefirot, the letters 22 are 22 of the mystical paths of wisdom by which this world was created, which I just love that story. Another nice story about the Aleph is that in Zohar, and you'll find all these links under here if you're interested in following through with them. In the Zohar, there's a story about all the letters coming before God to talk him into or convince God to put that letter first in Torah, which is the first five books of the Bible, you know, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. So that's the Torah, and it was a big deal to be the first letter. And so each one from Tav, which is the last letter forward, presented himself before God to ask to be the first letter in Torah. And he turned them all down, except for the Beit. And the Beit is female, and the Beit creates. So the Beit is the first letter. It's shaped sort of like this, is the first letter in Torah. And so that's the beginning, and then all the rest of the Torah comes out of here. I love that story. But the Aleph, the Aleph makes no sound. So the Aleph was just sitting there and not saying anything. And God said, well, aren't you going to say anything, Aleph? And Aleph said, well, you know, all the letters have gone before you and they've all been turned down and you picked the Beit, so there's really nothing left for me. And God said, oh, yes, he said, there is something left for you. You are going to be the first letter of the alphabet, and you will represent my unity forever, because of course it's the letter one. So I'm going to show you some of my Aleph paintings, so this is one. This is the Aleph hugging an angel. And this is a general in the Israeli army. The general is called Aleph Rosenberg, or whatever his last name is. So isn't he cute? And this is one when the Aleph and I went skiing in Sun Valley. The Aleph really liked to ski, and so did the Zion, or the, whatever. Anyway, so this is the Aleph skiing. And this is the Aleph giving a ride to the girl. He's bouncing her up and down on his leg like a swing. That was really fun. That was one of my meditations. Well, they all come to me in meditation. And this is the girl giving a hug to the Aleph. Because she just loves him. I just love the Aleph. Well, I just love all the letters. But I love the Aleph. And then I wanted to put this one up, and you can hold it there for a couple seconds. You can pause the, because you're going to need a pencil and paper, so you need to stop or pause it right here, and then you can copy. You can just copy it on the monitor. So there's the Aleph that you can copy. And so I'd like you to turn off the monitor, turn off the video, and just sit. We'll draw it first, and then if you're really ambitious, you can use crayons or watercolors or acrylics to make it more your own Aleph. And my Alephs always come to me that way. And when you come back, we'll do a meditation on the Aleph. I just love the Aleph. I get so excited about these letters. They are alive to me. I decided to study, to learn Hebrew in my 40s. I think I said that before. And the letters came to me in meditation. So they were alive. And so they're still alive to me. And they, anyway, we'll see what happens in this meditation. Now, always with a guided meditation, if you're not comfortable, you do not follow the person leading the meditation. So if you're not comfortable with meditation, you don't follow me. So here, let us relax. Take a few deep breaths. And now picture your Aleph. I'm going to tell you what my Aleph looks like. I'm walking towards the Aleph, and I'm on clouds. You know, in meditation, you can do anything, so I mean, I can walk through the clouds. And I walk for a little bit, and then the Aleph starts coming towards me. So we meet, and the Aleph gives me this huge hug, which Alephs are so good about. They just love to hug. And so I'm going to tell you what my Aleph looks like. This Aleph is, I've never painted one like this. It's pale, it's pastel colors of blue and green and yellow and pink and purple. Really pretty. So now my Aleph needs an outline color. So I'm going to outline it in blue, which turns out to be the predominant color in the Aleph. And you can just be there and enjoy your Aleph for as long as you like. And all the links from which I did the research on the letters are in the writing underneath the video. And I thank you so much, so very much for being with me as we learned about the Aleph.